Stanford.
Okay, so I guess I'm being put on the stage already. Welcome everybody to the Westside Computer Club. We're open. I'll have our open forum first, and who'd like to open up the floor with the first question of the evening for our May edition? Okay.
I'll go.
Yes, go ahead, Dennis.
So I just got a Windows 10 laptop a month or so ago. It came with McAfee installed, and I guess that self-installed is running. I want to get rid of it. So do all I need to do is go to, you know, control panel, add remove programs, and is it as simple as uninstall and I'm done, or are there any complications?
Bob?
Antivirus. Get their uninstaller from that company.
That's correct.
For that product.
McAfee and Norton both require you to get their tool from their website, and it will properly remove everything on the product. If you don't do that, you'll leave a lot of trash behind. Some of it could cause problems later down the road.
Good to know.
Revo uninstaller.
Not for antivirus.
It'll get part of it, but not all of it.
Problem with antivirus is it can reach inside the system kernel and put in drivers. These also have to be torn out.
Okay.
And it can only be safely done in Windows Safe Mode. But these uninstallers will take care of all that.
Doesn't Revo first invoke the programs uninstaller and then it cleans up the mess afterwards?
Yeah, but McAfee, Symantec, and these other suites do not have an uninstaller per se. They have a removal tool you have to download separately.
Okay.
And so does Avast, and it's just free antivirus. It has to do with what they do inside the Windows kernel.
Are there people using McAfee or here in our group here? Or
anyone using McAfee in the group?
No? Okay. All right. Yeah, I want to get rid of it.
We have people using Macs, but not McAfee.
Yeah, and those Macs, they say, they don't get viruses, so you don't need to put in an antivirus.
BS. And I've got two Macs, and trust me, I wouldn't have them without an AV, and I'm the one that posts all the articles about security issues, so I know what's going on.
Even with Linux, you have to take some precautions.
Yes.
More to come on the 18th.
Right. Okay, next question, new direction.
Did the meeting start already?
Yeah.
Yes.
We just started.
Oh, okay, I thought it wasn't supposed to start till 7 o'clock.
No, 7:30.
7:30.
7:30, and it's just now 7:30.
Yeah,
I just asked. That's all.
No, Ed, you are absolutely right, because when I was asked to start this, I said it wasn't 7:30.
No, Ed, it depends what time zone you're in. That's
easy now, boys.
Blame Stan.
I've got an app.
I'll take the blame. Don't worry.
Give Stan the credit. He's the one that wanted to start.
Carl, did I see your hand up?
Yes.
Yeah, I got a question.
I want to.
Have you heard anything yet?
Tom, hold up. Okay. Carl's talking.
I want to stream baseball, the Cubs games and the Sox games. What streaming service would people recommend?
I may cover that a little bit later on.
Okay. And
if not, by the way, ask the question.
By the way, a little hint, MLB.com does have those. I don't know if they're free.
We'll talk about those. Will come up during our presentation tonight, hopefully. Okay, so hold that question.
Thank you.
Good. Carl, we can't really see you very well. Is there a way to put a light on your face or not?
Don't do that, please. You don't want to see that smile.
Yeah, we don't want to break the camera.
All right. While he's, look at that. He does have a light there. There
he was a witness protection program.
Okay. Joe Hendricks, we can't see you at all. If you have a way to turn on your light or a picture. Tom Soltis, you had a question?
Yeah, I just had a question about is there any talk about going back to having regular meetings? Like, does the, you know, Naperville, are they opening up yet? Or
I don't know if they're open up yet. We're throwing the subject matter around at the board meeting.
Well, I'll tell you.
In fact, I may have a polling question later on today just to get an idea of what the members are thinking.
Okay, well, regardless of what the members are thinking, Naperville is still pretty much closed down. The band tried to get a band concert going, and they had all kinds of restrictions on them. They had to be, everything had to be set up differently on the stage. They even bought masks set up for trumpets and all, you know, French horns, all of the horns, bugles, whatever, and that they had to put over the musical instruments because they didn't want the breath to be shot out, as it were, when they're blowing the horn. So they're being a little strict. I don't know what they do with us as a computer society and how we would sit 6 feet apart from one another and wear masks.
You can tell them we're used to viruses.
I don't know. For my money, I'd rather Zoom, actually.
That's sad, man.
But okay, next question, new direction.
Okay, I've got a question.
Okay.
I'm probably jumping ahead on this, but can you take the output of what I want to say, the cable box that you have, and plug it right into your PC through HDMI and get a result?
No, it's encrypted. You need a cable card. Cable card.
Okay. That's what I thought.
Which the cable company I thought was mandated that they had to make available to you at one time. I don't know if the law changed.
There may be a small fee, but yes.
Right. So you can get a device like there is an HD Home Run Prime. That's an old device, but there are devices out there like that, which you can put a cable card into, and then you can be able to record right off a cable.
Hevo makes at least 2 Bolt devices, which will do that.
But there's a better option. There is another option out there of a software solution that you could run that will actually, a service that you can DVR your stuff from your cable card. And it'll come to me in a bit. I'll do a little quick research to see what the name is of this product. But it's been getting some really good reviews, if you will.
Okay. I was just curious.
Okay.
Okay. That was not part of my presentation. But,
And, of course, there's also this cloud DVR that many services offer.
I know.
Next question. Oh, I don't see anybody.
No hands?
No hands. Oh, Ed's got one. Yay. Ed, go ahead, Ed.
Yeah, I've been looking to pick up a iPhone 6S or later. Any idea where to pick one up? My wife has a iPhone 6, and I wanted to get a Apple Watch for her.
Have you checked out Gazelle?
Gazelle?
No. Gazelle with a G.
No.
Who's the provider?
Gazelle is a legitimate company that will buy and sell resell Apple products.
Who's your provider, Ed?
Right now it's Verizon. And I know I can get one through if I switch to T-Mobile. I've just been doing a lot of work on that. But it's, I'd almost like to just get a 6S just so she could try it and see if she likes it. Not the 6S, but the, I have an extra, I have a Series 5 watch, and I also have a Series 3 watch. And I just wanted her to try the Series 3. But when I went, normally I have, I use Mac Tracker, the Mac Tracker app, and it's usually accurate. Well, on this case, it said my Series 3 watch would be compatible with an iPhone 6, a 5S and a 6, something like that, it said. Turns out I spent an hour on the phone with Apple Care trying to get it to work, only to find out that that's not true. You have to have a 6S. So.
Why get a 6S? You'd probably get a 7 at the same price.
Yeah, well, I said a 6S or newer.
But, well, see,
a 6S or newer? Okay. Didn't know
I
that.
I have an iPhone and a Series 5 watch. I've had them for about a year. Now, the watch was brand new because I'm in a medical study with Apple and Stanford University, and I got the watch for $50 plus regular sales tax on the full original cost. And I picked up a iPhone 8 used under $200. That's a year ago. So by now, an iPhone 8 ought to be down to $150 or less.
So where did you get it?
I got it, if I remember correctly, through eBay, and it was a Texas outfit. That's all I remember offhand.
Okay, great.
But there's a lot of legitimate companies like Sanford's alluding to that do sell Apple products used. And so far, I even picked up a couple other little odds and ends that all of them work just fine as advertised.
Right. Okay.
Okay, I found the name of the product. It's a software solution. It's called Channels. Channels.com, and it's a DVR service that will let you record over the air as well as cable provided content, and you could DVR it, and it's legit currently.
Okay, thank you.
How does that work, Sanford? I'm not quite sure I understand that one. You don't have the actual DVR. It's
done in the cloud. It's all done in the cloud. Yep.
Okay.
Done in the cloud, and then you can watch it anywhere. Once you record it, it's in your box, so to speak, and you can watch it anywhere you're traveling to.
Is it a monthly service, monthly mm-hmm. payment service subscription?
I believe so. Please look into it. I just have heard about the product, but I really have not investigated it because I didn't need it. So just look it up. Go to channels.com. I think that's the URL. And that should be able to help you. Let's see. Let me do that again. Channels.com. And see if that comes up. Channels. Oh, getchannels.com. GETchannels.com. Live TV anywhere. And then if you go to there, you can find out how it works, you know, how to make it all happen. It may be free. I don't know if there's a subscription to it or not. Next question, new direction. Yes, Ed, you're back.
Yes, I'm back. Hey, two things. One, you're linked to the Zoom when you did the thing on the drones.
Yes.
I really like that. I couldn't make it, and it was really a great job. But I do have one other question. How are you doing, knowing that you had COVID? Are you completely over it?
We'll make this real brief because it doesn't belong here. But yes, I'm over it. Couple of lingering things. Saw my doctor today. He says, you know, I need to exercise and do a few things, but I'm over it. So me and the vaccine, we had some problems, but got the vaccines and I'm good. And I'll just leave it at that so we could stay on topic.
Right. Okay. Thanks.
Okay. All right. If you want to know more, we could talk privately, Ed.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Seems like the okay. Next question, Ed. I know you had tons of questions for us. You haven't been hanging around us, PC people. And Ed, I gotta confess to you, my family had persuaded me to become an Apple iPhone owner. So I am now in the Apple universe, kicking and screaming. I moved away from my Samsung products, and now I'm into the Apple universe. And I even own an Apple Watch, too. Ooh.
Ooh.
Sam, did you try the faces I told you about?
Yeah. Yes, I did.
Okay.
Oh, welcome to my place.
It looks like Bob researched that Get Channels a bit. He's got a little note in the chat. No more questions.
Let me just, like it.
Did anyone buy anything new in this last 30 days or so? No.
Well, I know you probably did, Sanford.
Oh, yeah, I did. I bought a new sensor for my dishwasher because it wasn't heating up the water right. So the dirty water sensor went bad. And
That's not computer related.
And let's see, what else did I buy? I bought a new heat detent sensor in there for that one. Well, I had to use the computer to go online to diagnose what my problem is. YouTube, great place to go. Okay. Something broken, good place to go to learn how to fix it. Go to YouTube.
Just a quick review of what I told some of the members earlier. We're going to cut the open forum at 7 o'clock, maybe a little earlier.
Seven? We eight. Didn't start
I mean, it's at 8. At 8. I'm still dreaming.
I know you're still asleep.
No, I had a procedure today, and they put me to sleep.
They put you to sleep. Okay,
yeah.
I got that. Jerry, yeah, you're okay?
I'm somewhat okay.
Okay.
I came home and slept the afternoon. So
good man. Naps are good for you.
My wife is in the veterinary industry. So when you use the term put me to sleep, it has a totally different meaning.
Oh, yeah. 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 Well, they do put the animals to sleep if they do a surgery or something like that. So that varies.
That's not what he's talking about.
I know.
It's usually called knock them out.
Yeah. But I just wanted to say, you know, that I've been under the weather all day, and I'm doing pretty good right now.
Good.
What's your temperature?
Probably 97.1.
He meant your CPU. He meant your CPU.
Easy, gentlemen. Easy now.
Dennis, what does your wife do in the veterinary industry?
Well, when I first met her, she was she worked at an animal hospital in the Romeoville area, kind of as help everything, reception, help the doctor in surgery, everything like that. Then she spent 20 years as a salesperson calling on veterinary hospitals, selling them everything from drugs, cages, syringes, medicine, anything you can think of. And right now, she and I both retired. She works part-time at Arlington Heights Cat Clinic as a receptionist 2 days a week. So just a little bit of a mix of everything.
Oh, my sister works in Pullman at Cragness Animal Hospital. She's a vet.
Okay. Where's that animal hospital at?
It's in Pullman.
Pullman neighborhood. South side of Chicago.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, my wife called on accounts mostly in northwest suburbs up to the Wisconsin border, more or less. And she had a territory.
Yeah. My sister's doing the veterinary stuff, and I get to hear about surgeries ad nauseum.
My stepdaughter
had and what she did, and it's like, please stop talking. I don't want to know about the geeky parts.
My stepdaughter is a vet. She owns the emergency veterinary service out there in Lyle. Sanford was the one that helped design their sign.
Cool.
Yeah, my company designed the logo for them.
Right.
As she was starting up. And she's pretty successful. And I also made sure that I made several visits there with animals to help subsidize and more than paid for whatever we ever earned for her.
Yeah.
And fees to save my poor dog.
Yeah, they've got the thing all paid off and then some.
Well, the last dog we had, he lived to 18. And, oh, my God, she could not let this dog go. Until he finally began to shut down. And it's like, okay, Marisa, so we got to let him go at some point. Poor dog. Sorry. I didn't mean to get us off topic.
Off topic.
I wanted to make a comment about the iPhones.
Yes.
Not all the iPhones are the same. Depending upon which service you have, there's two different technologies. So, you know, Verizon is different than the AT&T.
Are you saying that you can't transfer the AT&T iPhone over to Verizon?
I don't believe you can because it's got different technology.
Nope, can't do that.
Pardon?
No, you can't do that.
Yeah. Unless it's unlocked, isn't it? If you get an unlocked phone?
No, there were some phones created with both the major services. I know Verizon was CMDA or something like that.
CDMA.
Okay.
CDMA.
Then T-Mobile and AT&T use the other
CDMA?
GSM.
GMA.
GSM and CDMA are the protocols.
Right. Yeah. Those are the two primary.
They are not compatible. They require separate SIM cards.
Yeah. Right. But there were some phones, not a lot, I don't think, that have the ability to handle one or the other, but only one at a time.
There are also some with dual SIM capabilities that can handle both.
That's true.
They're mostly sold in Europe, though.
Yes.
I know I keep getting Xfinity wants me to switch over to them. And I asked them about it, and they said I'd have to buy a new phone from them because my AT&T phone wouldn't work on their system.
Yeah, there are probably differences there.
So that's why I want to mention that somebody's looking to buy used iPhone, they better make sure which one they're getting.
Yeah, T-Mobile, I believe, is CDMA.
And so is AT&T.
Okay. They're the main ones that are. I forget what Sprint used to be. Well, Sprint is T-Mobile now.
Yes, they're CDMA here.
CDMA was Verizon.
Right.
It's not, yeah. AT&T is GSM.
Right.
GSM? Okay.
Xfinity is Verizon.
Right.
The Xfinity service uses Verizon?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Doesn't Sprint own TracFone also?
Anybody? Could be.
Sprint is now T-Mobile.
Yeah.
I thought they bought TracFone. I'm not sure. That's what I have, is TracFone.
That was back yonder.
Who owns Cricket?
AT&T.
AT&T.
I'm sorry? AT&T?
AT&T.
So yeah, Cricket uses AT&T's cells?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have a third-tier reseller that U.S. Mobile, and they, in my area, use Verizon, but they used to use T-Mobile.
Okay.
Consumer cellular uses the AT&T system, too.
Okay. So, yeah, there will be differences.
Anyone else buy anything new?
I bought a new refrigerator, Samsung.
Okay.
But I haven't quite dared to explore it in depth as yet. Because I'm afraid to connect it to the computer system. I think it might be shocking or very cold, get a cold shoulder.
Yeah. Oh, so this one's a smart refrigerator?
Yeah, it's smart. I can do anything, program it or do anything from away from home. And it's like, that scares the hell out of me. And I'm just timid, you know? I'll plunge into it.
You had a whole touchscreen service on the front of it, on the refrigerator itself, too.
Right. Mm-hmm. There is concern, Tony, there is concern out there in the ether, if you will, about Internet of Things devices similar to your refrigerator, about the fact that they don't necessarily have good firewalls. They definitely do not have anything like antivirus on there. So be guarded on how you're going to let it have access to your network.
Appreciate that, yeah.
You may want to do a little quick research to see how you can limit what it can do once it's on your network. So that, and that's not saying that the refrigerator is going to go and hack your other computers, but because some of the IoT things don't have good firewalls, hackers have been able to use them as a gateway to get into your network. So set up some parameters on what you allow it to do and not allow it to do. And I can't advise you anyway about it.
Yeah,
Dennis has some info.
No, I was just going to say, so your refrigerator can freeze the network? Is that what we're saying?
Easy, boy, easy. Not no.
There are devices that are available that you connect your IoT devices to that connects to your internet and provides some level of protection from the hacking situation. I know Avast has one, and I know there were a couple others. I haven't looked into any of them offhand, but you're correct, Sanford. They are a high-risk area, and it's worse for businesses because a lot of businesses have and rely upon IoT devices, and that creates a weak link in cybersecurity for our businesses.
I read recently. Sorry.
Yeah.
I read recently.
But just to keep them on two different systems. In other words, you know, don't put your computer on the same network. You know, if you've got two different systems on your modem, you know, the 2.4 and the 5 gigahertz, then you can put one on your computer on one and then put all your IoTs on the other.
It won't matter because you've got one pipe into your place usually. And so it won't make a difference. And most IoT devices, unless there's been a change I didn't notice lately, are 2.4 gigahertz.
Right. Yeah.
But you would be better off creating a guest account on the router, and that attach the IoT devices to the guest account. That gives you a little bit of protection for your regular internal Wi-Fi network and any Ethernet that you may use. But I think the other devices that are available to try and provide protection will go a level above guest account in the router. Most of the routers will have their firewall on, but the information on virtually all the firewalls out there that manufacturers are using have in dark places on the internet all the information needed for hackers to break through the firewall into your internal network in your home or business. And that's what the vulnerability is, because then they attack the weak spot, which is your IoT devices, and they in turn help attack your regular devices, even if they have the their own firewall on. Like when you're on a Windows device or a Mac, you have a firewall on, and but it's lightweight unless you have an AV package that includes a heavyweight replacement of Windows firewall.
I discovered recently, I was looking into having, you know, those cameras in my front door, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. And I've discovered where they said Ring doorbells are susceptible to easy manipulation as opposed to whatever else they have over there.
There's a lot of different security issues with virtually all of them because it is an IoT device, and therefore it is susceptible because there is no AV, there is no firewall. So it's very easy to hack these things, and that's how also they do like baby monitors. The bad part there is the people who have the baby monitors do not read the instructions or don't understand how to read the language. But it tells you, you have to change the password. If you change the password, you increase your level of security. If you leave it as is, all the bad guys out there know what the password is. So they can tap right into your baby monitor and be talking to your kids, watching you do things. If you're a person who likes to go around the house in your birthday suit, they got films of it.
I can't afford those suits, man. That's a big suit. Man.
I do like the idea of using a guest account. I have a one Wi-Fi camera, and I have that only affixed to my guest account.
Mm-hmm. So, well, what the guest account does is it, shall we say, circumvents your internal normal Wi-Fi Ethernet and allows a guarded way of getting in and out of the internet via the same device. But it's not perfect. Nothing is. But at least it's a level of protection beyond what normally we would use in our homes.
Thank you.
Got some good tips there, Tony.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, the tips will come later on.
Bob's posting a lot of stuff on the chat. Yeah. I recommend you take a look at it.
Yeah, good
stuff. He's got some FBI recommendations in there. So
Bob will keep you going straight here.
Yes, and there's also an explanation of what a virtual LAN or VLAN is, so you can create that extra network within a standard router.
Okay.
And I think the instructions will be simple enough. It comes from ZDNet.
In short, Tony, the refrigerator, as wonderful as it is, will be your weakest link on your network.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
You've probably been doing stellar on everything else, but that one could be, you got to watch it.
The weak link in the chain.
Weakest link in the chain.
You just gave me the chills, sir.
Well, I mean, if you want to utilize it, you paid for it. You want to utilize the service. Just,
I agree.
You know what you're getting into when you open up that door of the fridge.
I get cold feet, sir.
Just set it up, secure it, and then chill out.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Stuff. Yeah, chilly.
Okay, any other last questions or comments? Anybody else got anything they bought? They want to brag about? No? All right. Well, then I guess I'll call this completed and turn this back over to Jerry.
Okay. Thank you, Sam.
You're welcome.
To kind of figure out what options are available, not to how to hook it up, but all the different options that are out there. So we'll go through and see what we got. You know, there are remote control and voice-controlled options for some of the streaming videos. This is fairly new. One thing that I've got a Logitech remote control that I control my TV, my audio receiver, and cable box, all with one button. It turns
Jerry,
on.
Yeah. Jerry, I'm not able to. Oh, it just cleared up. Your screen is not showing up.
Is it now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Also, Jerry, you've had some audio issues where you're cutting in and out.
Possibly part and parcel of the same thing.
Closer. But if there's more problems, let me know. Let me see that I'm plugged in. Yeah, I'm plugged in. Good. Okay. Getting back to my Logitech control, cable boxes on, but they put it to the right channel that I want. In case the TV is not at HDMI, it will move it to HDMI. In case the audio receiver is not to the correct option, it will move it to there. So I got it real easy, and those are some of the things I'm looking at to make sure that I can can you use multiple TVs? That depends on what type of streaming service you have. And then, depending upon how you're hooked up, you might get the sound in the TV, but I like my sound coming through my audio system, through my speakers, throughout the
cutting in and out, Jerry.
Well, let me do. I don't know what's going on.
I agree. I probably missed about 50% of what you said, Jerry. It's just cutting in and out. And
right now, the display is all blurry.
If I recall, Jerry, you had problems in the past with your internet connection going out.
Yeah.
Let me.
It could, it could be that, I hate to say it, but it could be because you're recording the session. You're
I'm not recording the session on the PC that I am on.
No, yeah. But it might be if you're doing on another machine, it could be sucking in your bandwidth. I'm just speculating here.
Yeah, I've never had any problems with that. Let me stop screen share. Let me go to audio.
Thanks for the cookie, Stan.
How about now? Can you hear me?
Yes.
I can hear you.
I can hear you.
But I can't see you.
Here, can see, but I don't.
I'm not in shared screen right now.
No.
I just got a message. My internet connection is unstable.
Yeah.
I can't control that.
Yeah, change a carrier.
Well, see what happens.
Bill Powell, I sent you a private text.
I saw that. It confused me. I'll read it again. Maybe.
Oh, where'd it go? Where the heck did my presentation go?
Apparently, I can't look at that while he's sharing screen, Sanford.
My question was about that gaming rig you were putting together.
Me?
Weren't you doing one with your son or something?
No.
Okay, then never mind.
I don't want that one. In a shared screen?
Yeah, we see it, Jerry.
Okay.
Questions I have?
Let me continue. Okay. Of course, you need wireless internet on your TV. I have my TV going, whether it's music, my cable, or games, or it sets up, you know, the TV, the audio receiver, and the cable box, all with one click.
We're having that blur out problem like we had last month with you.
Yeah. Yeah, I see that. Yeah. Let me go back to the actual.
You got somebody in the waiting room.
I took care of it.
Who was it, Sanford?
Dave, somebody.
Howdy.
Huh?
I said howdy.
Howdy, howdy, partner, howdy.
Well, it must be, but I don't know where they are. Point presentation. Is it any better now?
No.
No. Huh. What the heck is going on? Let me